Hey everyone, today I'm going to be showing you how to make a halftone shake on Premiere Pro. This is the finished result, and as always, you're going to need the Sapphire plugin installed. So let's get started. Head to your project tab, right click, new item, adjustment layer, click OK, place it above your first clip. So what I'm going to be doing is working on this one and then duplicate it over to my other clips. So what I'm going to be using is Blur Mode Curves. You can use Transform if you prefer, but Blur Mode Curves gives me more freedom and it's easier to work with. So what I'm going to do is keyframe the Z dist and set this to 0.75, and then I'm going to move the center XY point up so then I can center it to my character. And then what I'm going to do is head to the last frame and reset this back to 1. I'm going to graph it, so open up your graph, head one frame back, use the velocity to help you. I'm going to grab this, pull it down, and need to make sure the velocity is around 0, so 0.1, that should do. I'm happy with that, so I'm going to push this keyframe back and then I'm going to tighten this side up like that. Okay, let's take a look. Looks okay. In fact, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to change the Z dist. Let's go for 0.5 at the beginning instead, just for more impact. Looks great. So I'm going to minimize this effect and add on Blur Mode Curves once more. Then what I'm going to do is keyframe Z dist. Let's go for 0.9 at the start, and then head to the end, 1.1. Then set both the wrap X and Y to reflect, like so. And also what I'm going to do is move the XY once more, so slightly higher. Did that make a difference? It did. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is graph this. So I'm going to grab the handle for the first keyframe and drag it right slightly down until it touches 0. Perfect. So I'm going to leave this one at the very, not at the very end, but on the last frame instead of pushing it to the end. So I'm just going to leave it there and tighten this. There you go. Now let's take a look. Looks great. So what I'm going to do now is just collapse this effect as well. The next one we're going to add is S shake. So search for S_shake. So it should be this one underneath Sapphire Distort. Add it onto the same adjustment layer and you want to copy my settings. Set the amplitude to 2, the frequency to 12, turn on the motion blur and set the blur length to 4. Now open up the X shake and change the rand amp to 4, and then open up the Y shake just underneath it. Set this one to 6 and it should look like this, creating a jitter effect. However, if you don't like the motion blur, what you can do is disable it. So just uncheck this box and you'll still get the jitter. It just won't be as effective. So you could turn up the frequency to maybe like 18. And I guess that kind of works, but I prefer it with motion blur on. So I'm going to leave it checked. Now collapse this as well. And what we're going to do is add on another effect called blur directional. So S_blur directional onto the same adjustment layer and copy my settings once again. Set the amount to 75, leave the angle at negative 45, change the shift to 5 and the brightness 2. Then you want to head 5-10 frames ahead, set the blur amount to 0, the angle to negative 500 and the shift to 0. And then what you want to do is head 5 more frames ahead and set the brightness to 1. Highlight all 4 of these keyframes here at the end, right click on one of them and select ease in right here. Now you should have some sort of twitch shake that looks like this. Unfortunately, it for some reason does lag, so you won't really see the result until you render the edit or render a preview, but we're just going to trust the process and hope it turns out well. So what you want to do next is make a reverse shake, so before it transitions over to your next clip. And we're going to do that by heading to the last frame on the adjustment layer. And what you want to do is set some keyframes. So set the blur amount to 25, the angle to 300, the shift to, then you want to head 5 frames back and set the amount to 0, the angle to negative 500, the shift to 0. And then you want to highlight these keyframes here, right click, linear. Then you want to highlight these first 3 keyframes, right click, ease out. And now you've got a delicate build up shake, which is going to work really well once we duplicate the adjustment layer over to our other clips. Okay, let's collapse this effect. And next you want to search for Flicker. or Sapphire Flicker. So it should be the one underneath Sapphire Time, S underscore Flicker. You can either add it onto your adjustment layer or your clip directly. Sometimes it doesn't work on an adjustment layer, but I'm going to use it on this anyway, so I'm just going to drag and drop and head back into effect controls. You can either leave it as it is, or you can change the random frequency down to 20. Collapse this effect, and what we're going to do is duplicate this adjustment layer over to our other clip. So hold Alt on your keyboard, click and drag. Click and drag. So we're pretty much done with everything except for the actual halftone. So what we're going to do is add one more adjustment layer on top. This has to be done separately. So I'm just going to place it on top and extend. And what you want to do is search for S underscore halftone underneath Sapphire Stylize. So add this one onto the adjustment layer. And the first thing you want to do is change the blend mode to overlay. Underneath opacity, you want to set a stopwatch for the opacity, of course. So hit that at the beginning. So this should be set to 100. Head about 10 frames ahead. But if you want the halftone to be visible for longer, then head 15 frames ahead instead. And what you want to do is decrease the opacity all the way down to 0. Then open up the graph. And what you can do is just right click on the second keyframe and ease in. So you can leave it as this, or you can go further. So what I'm going to do is pull it to the left very slightly. So yeah, just copy my graph if you would like to. I'm going to collapse the opacity, so scroll down and copy my settings for the halftone. Head to the beginning and set a keyframe for the dot frequency. Set it to 75. Head about 5-10 frames ahead and change it to 100, like that. Then you want to graph it, so open it up and put it to the left. So make it look something like this. Make sure it's leveled as always, not too high or too low. I always say that. So like that. And it's going to look like this. However, as I said before, you can make it last longer. So you can push it closer to the opacity. In fact, I think it just makes more sense. So do that. Align it with the opacity and you should have these two keyframes in total. Once again, duplicate this over to your other clips. So hold Alt, click and drag. Whoops, don't do that. Click and drag, just like that. And you're pretty much done. If you want to check, head to the beginning, press I on your keyboard, head to the very last frame just here and press O. Then what you want to do is head over to sequence at the top, sequence settings. And what you want to do is change the preview file format to QuickTime, the codec to Apple ProRes 422, uncheck both of these boxes, leave this one checked and reset, click OK. And then what you want to do is head into sequence again and select render into out at the top. And that's going to render a preview. So this is the result and it looks perfect. Did you know that you can grab all of these presets as part of my premium preset pack? From shakes to colorings to transitions and more, there are 50 presets in total and you can grab it in the description below. If you're interested, then check out this video here. Otherwise, thank you very much for watching. I hope this video helped, and I'll see you next time. Peace.